Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to remove text from a photo. And this works really well with photos that don't have a lot of variation in the background. If there's a lot of variation, you'll have to use longer ways of doing it, like using the clone stamp and that kind of thing. All right, let's get started. All right, so I'm here in Photoshop and I'm just going to go to Open. And then I've got an image right here that has some text over the top of it. I'll open that. Now this is just an ad I found online, but a good use of this would be something like you download a photo from a stock site and it has text on it that you don't want. This is an easy way to get rid of it. So I'm going to get my lasso tool right over here. You can hit L on your keyboard too. And I'm just going to select the text and get it close to it, but you don't have to get right up next to it. And then I'll switch to my M tool, which is the rectangular marquee, and hold shift and get this one down here. Now I'll come up here to select color range. I'm gonna click on select and choose the highlights. So you can see it's kind of isolating the text from the background. We can adjust the fuzziness and range. So I'm gonna bump the range up to kind of knock out those background colors. But I also wanna adjust the fuzziness a little bit. Now I still have a little bit of the background here, but that's okay. I'll go ahead and say okay. So now we have the text selected for the most part. I'll come up here to select and then choose modify, and we're going to expand this selection by, I'm thinking 3 pixels, and I'll say okay. Now I'm gonna check out my quick mask. I'll hit Q on my keyboard, and this shows us that everything that's red is selected. So you can see a little bit here that we don't want selected. So I'm going to go ahead and erase that. I'll hit E on my keyboard, and I'm holding control and option and then dragging to the right to make my brush bigger. I want black to be in the front, so I'm gonna hit X to switch those. And if you have different colors here, you can just hit D on your keyboard to get white and black there. Then I can erase those reddish areas back there. You're basically erasing the selection, so just be careful you don't erase some of the selection here. Okay, and this looks pretty good. I'm gonna hit Q again to go out of quick mask mode. So now we have a pretty clean selection of our text. I'm gonna come up here to edit, content aware fill. It takes a second. You can see it did a pretty good job. We've got some artifacts here and we've got something down here. So I'm gonna cancel. I'm gonna go ahead and increase my selection. So select, modify, and expand again. We'll go 3 more pixels. And now let's try it again. Edit, content aware fill. And this got almost everything. So I'm pretty happy with this. We'll say okay. And then I'll hit Command D or Control D on a PC to deselect everything. And I'm gonna zoom in. You can see here that we have a little bit of work to do still. So I'm gonna hit J on my keyboard. J will bring me up here to the spot healing brush. I'm gonna make my brush a little smaller. On a Mac, that's Control Option and then drag to the left. I'm gonna zoom in up here. And I'm just gonna go over these areas that didn't work very well. Okay, so now we have the background with no text on it. Now I'm going to try another image. So I'll go to File, Open, and this is another ad. I also got this one online, so it's really low res. Now because this is dark text on a light background, we're going to have to change something in Select Color Range. But first, let's highlight our text. And this time I'm going to use a quick mask to do that. So I'll hit Q on my keyboard, then I'll hit B. You'll want to make sure black is in front here, and then just draw over the top of whatever you want to select. I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller. And I'm going to click and hold shift to get that bottom text. Now I'll hit Q again to exit the quick mask and get our selection. I'll come up here to select color range. This time we'll select the shadows, and I'm going to increase the range here until I start getting the text, but not the background very much. And this is definitely how it'll look with a low res image. It'll be very pixelated, and that's okay. We'll say okay. And now I'll hit Q to see if there's some extra stuff we can delete. I'm gonna make sure white is in front and get on my brush and just delete these little areas. And I'll hit Q again to get my selection back. I'm gonna go to select, modify, and expand. And we'll put 3 pixels. And I think this is good because if you zoom in, you can see this pixely stuff. It'll help to get rid of that. Maybe we want to do it even a little more. I'll go select, modify, and expand. And this time I'm going to go 2 pixels. I'll zoom out a little bit. And now the final step, edit, content aware fill. And it did a really good job this time of just getting rid of that text. We'll say okay. And then Command D or Control D to deselect. Now I want to show you one more example with a background that is pretty varied that it doesn't work that well with. So I'm going to drag this image onto my Photoshop icon. And here we have a lot of variation with our background. With this one, I'm just going to use my rectangular marquee. So I'll hold shift and draw another box. I'll come up here to select color range. And we want the highlights on this one. Okay, and with this one, these settings are giving me a really nice result. So I'll go ahead and say okay. I'll go to select, modify, expand, and we'll do 2 pixels and say okay. Next, we'll go to edit, content aware fill. Because we have a hard edge up here, Photoshop doesn't know what to do with what's behind these letters. And same here, it just doesn't really know what to do. So I'm going to go ahead and say okay and hit Command D or Control D. And to fix this part, I'll probably just copy this area over here. I'll get on my clone stamp tool and make my brush a little bit bigger, and I'll hold Option or Alt and just click right along this edge. I'll start from right here. I'm gonna clone this part to get rid of that. So when you have an image like this, you'll have to go back in and make some edits because like this part down here doesn't look good. This isn't right. And you might find that the content aware fill just isn't working for your image. And in that case, you'll have to find other ways to make it work. But I just wanted to show you that what can happen when there's a lot of variation and detail in the background. All right, I hope this video was useful for you. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.